Hello, ladies. Welcome back to my channel. I'm looking for my glasses. Welcome back to my channel. For all those that don't know me, my name is Laura. Hit that like, subscribe button, leave a comment. Today, I will be bringing to you a sewing. Yes, I was tossing it up and I was undecided about what I wanted to do to my hair. I was going to do some crochet braids. I even took and pre-braided me some box braids so I can install them for crochet braids, and I curled it. And then after I finished, they looked so pretty. I was like, oh, I don't want to install them yet. I think I'm going to use them for something else. Then I took and did me some rope twists with some Molly hair. And when I finished with that, I was like, they're cute. I'm going to use it for something else. So I was like, you know what? My husband said, girl, I wish you do something. So I was like, because what I'm doing is, you know, I be making my little wig hats. So when I do little styles and I make my little pre-braids and stuff, I like the pre-braided hair that I braid myself compared to the crochet hair when I buy it to add to my wig hats, because they're not as bulky. Like, they look more natural. That's why, you know what I mean? So when I do them and they look pretty up, like, I'm using that for my hat. So today I'm going to do a sew-in. Again, I let you ladies know over and over again that in my room, that I do my hair in, I have a bin, one of the outside bins, that I have full of hair. And I'm, look here, just hair. So I was like, you know what? I'm not buying anything. And you know, I be doing these little videos and I just be pulling hair out the box. So whatever I have in there, I'm pulled out, trying to mix it. Some days I toss it up, like, oh, I'm going to use this. Then I'm like, no, I'm not going to use that. But, you know, today, I'm going to use this sewing. I paid, this bag was $20. It's the Kimma Master Top Grade Premium Fiber Moist Capture Grade AAAAA. A ripple deep, no tangle, shed free. The most natural hair texture is a 14, 16, 18, 18 inch with free closure. It's the color one. It says heat sensitive up to 350. So beyond comparison, everything in one pack. Hope you can see that. Let me lay it down like this. Everything in one pack. This is the back. So that's what we're gonna do today. I'm just gonna sit here and I'm just gonna sew this up. And your ladies are going to be my audience and watch me. As we pull it out. Take the net off. You know, I always make sure I save these nets, especially if I wear a sewing weave like this with the crinkle curl, because I use this net to put on top of the hair when I'm not doing nothing. I put the net on first and then put my hair bonnet on. So I always save my nets. So this is the hair. So let's see what the closure look like. All right, just a little piece of closure they give you, which is not bad. You got 2 18-inches. Just the 2 18-inches. Got a 16-inch. And we have a 14-inch. Just that quick, I was thinking about doing the 14-inch in the back and then do the 16 and the 18 to bring it longer to give me, but no, because I like my ponytails. My ponytails. You know, I like to pull something in the ponytail. Quick and easy. So that's what we have today. All right, ladies, so we're going to get started. So before I get started, I'm going to use the braid sheen. And all I'm going to do is spray my hair. So it has some type of moisture. On my hair itself. All right. As I open these tracks, they are so thin. Yes. So, I'm gonna do the front first. Yes, as you see, I sewed one part in already because I have to do that part off camera because it take long. It's basically pull about this much off like this. And then I clip it right here. Not clip it, but cut it. I'm doing my front because I have to do that off camera because I really need to be up in the mirror. So, and basically I'm just sewing it and then I'm overlapping it and overlapping it and overlap. Just keep overlapping it until I get all the way back here. And then I'll start going in and sewing around the front. You know, the front, when you're trying to close up the part, is always the hardest part. So, that's why I put the front on first, because it takes time. And you need to be in the mirror when you do that part. When I do the sew in the back, I can sit here and sew in and sew it around with, you know, without having the mirror. But definitely for the mirror, I need to be up close and personal so I can see exactly what I'm doing. And then I stay on track. I'm gonna try to do it on camera a little bit. I think doing my right side on camera might have been easier than doing my left side. And as you see, I didn't do no particular type of braid pattern. I didn't even show you my braid pattern. My bad. See my braid pattern? And basically it comes around on the side. Because I intended on doing crochet braids. So now that I have changed my mind, I have to improvise. That's basically what we do. Have a clip to try to hold. Yeah. Yes, I'm back. I'm still working on this top part. And I had to go into the mirror and look closely at it because sitting here doing it, when I got closer to the mirror, I noticed that the thread had a little loop in it. It wasn't going all the way through. So this is why, basically, like when you're doing your front part and you're doing it yourself, you want to try to be right in the mirror. Especially if you mess with curly hair, because you want to make sure you're laying everything down. So, yes, I'm almost there. All right, here we go. We got the top part in. So I laid it over to the side. All right, so we're going to get busy. Sorry, so here we go. This is the 18 inch. So I'm going to go ahead and double these width. Always take and put the needle through the width first to lock it and secure it in. And because these widths are so thin, I want to make sure I secure it take these glasses off. I'm gonna start and bring it around here on the side. That's why I do like to do it in the mirror, because when you pull the thread, you have to worry about, you can see exactly what you're doing. Trying to use the video camera as what I'm seeing. I'm still grabbing the thread. So, all right, let's get busy with that. Yes, all that finally, all that paperwork. Like, Jesus. Mama been working hard. It's official, people. It's official. I'm sorry. I'm back. I'm trying to do my hair, and it's official. I got a settlement date, baby. It's official. Thank you. Like I tell you, trying to get this paperwork together when you're trying to buy a home. When I tell you, they just coming after every little thing, and it's just like
that's what they do. Though. That's exactly what they do. And I told you when you first started working on that. I said near the end. After yes. You did all that hard work, they hit you right in the end with some whole bunch of other shit.
Yes.
And that's exactly what, that's how they work.
I was like, oh my that's goodness, week after week, I've been on top of all this paperwork.
But the surprising part is they was fucked up in there like this motherfucker got everything.
Yes. Every time they came for something, baby, mama was
like
ready.
You had to look for it or go yes. through no situation for it. It was like, y'all want it? Give me a couple of hours, I got you.
I got
and
you.
All that shit poured through.
Yes.
They like, God damn, this motherfucker.
Yes, I was just sending. I said, let me tell you, I went through two things of ink. So you make sure when you trying to buy a house, make sure you get plenty of ink, color, and black for your printer. Make sure you have a printer. Because, baby, you're going to be needing to email some stuff, fax some stuff, over copy some stuff.
You need all that.
Trust. Don't let nobody tell you different. I'm here to tell you. Because I was working that thing. And no, I'm not going to overlap this. I'm going to cut it because I don't want to loop it. Because you need not that much. I could take it right there, but let me see. Baby, mama's just excited about getting into this house.
I'm happy like that.
We go to settlement on Monday, March the 1st. Yes, it's been a blessing. It's been a blessing. Thank God.
A long road for that.
A long road. And we have started looking.
Remember last year we was talking about it, and then we
It's been like 3 years. The first time we really started looking into it was in 2018. And then after all the hassle, this, that, and third, and we couldn't find what we want, we let it alone. Then we started looking again in 2019. Then it was like, you know what? Forget it. We're going to leave it alone. We still ain't found what you want. Because one thing for sure, two things are certain. That racial barrier is there and will always be there when it comes to our color folks. Like when they try, when you trying to buy a house, they gonna always try to stick you in the roughest areas. You know what I mean? So, and we wasn't going for that. Why we not buying it?
Nope.
I'm not going to no cul-de-sac. I'm not going to no projects. I'm not going around a whole bunch of niggas. I'm not better than nobody. But however, I don't live like that, and I'm not trying to have all that chaos all up in my world. So I avoid that, and I'm looking to buy a house and be there for years. I'm getting older. I'm not trying to deal with all that. I got grandbabies coming up, and I'm just trying to live happily, comfortably, and in peace. My baby's coming with some food. I ain't going to never finish
Are
my hair,
baby. Like...
Yes. Look at my lunch. Baby, I ain't going to never finish my hair, so I'm going to have to come back, all right? Whoa, I'm finished from eating lunch. Thank you. It was delicious. All right, so let me start this second bundle right here.
How did you?
This hair is pretty soft. I like it. For $20? Fine by me, Bill. All right, cut that TV off.
This one?
Mm-hmm.
This one?
Yes.
My son is 8.
Thank you, baby. Enjoy. Thank you for lunchy lunch. My baby's so sweet. He makes sure I eat. All the time, girl. I'm never hungry. Yes, baby eat breakfast, lunch, and dinner, snacks. He always makes sure we got food. Love a man that can cook. I love my baby. With that being said, y'all need to check out our cooking channel. It's called Home Cooking with the Bellums. We be having fun. Like my kids be like, Mom, you be all into the YouTube. Because I enjoy making these little videos. I wish they had this out when I was younger. Like in my younger days, like I was really popping with doing hair. Like I got older, Mom had to push that half a century mark. So I'd be like, okay, doing stuff slowly but surely, but I'd be getting there. But back in the day, when I just used to be doing styles, knocking stuff out the water. You know what I mean? If YouTube would have been out there, I would have been had me over 1,000 subscribers and viewers and all the other stuff. Yes, I would have been one of those with millions and millions of people, thousands and thousands of people. But, of course, I'm not because I'm just getting started. So I'll get there because I think YouTube is a good platform to where I look at it as, you know, I can showcase my talent and put it out there for someone, beginners, who can look and see what I do and then take and tweak it, do what they do, you know. And it's always going to help somebody. No, not just that. I look at it as, you know, as I sit here, it's my legacy, like a live biography. You know, as I was going to sit down and do that too. You know, talk a little bit about my life, my children, who I love so much. I'm turning, start doing it in front. All right, so I turn around so y'all can see me doing the back. Need a way to go. Basically, I'm just filling for where the plait is and where the last track is. All right. I like my curvy needle more so than I like my straight needles, but basically I use what I have. So I have a mixture of each. So what I do is I have them already threaded right on the side. And what I have them sitting in, actually, I got this from my local dollar store, and this has a little squeaky toy in it. And actually, it's out the animal section, like the stuff they have for animals. So it has that foam and stuff in there. I use it to stick my pens in. Baby, convenient. Convenient. Basically, you see me just feeling for the track and where I want it to go. And I'm making sure that I hit the track right above where the part is between the two here so I can connect it together. And this part is just feeling for what it is that I'm trying to do to close up this little area. Just bringing it right around. There you have it. Need scissors. This hair feel nice and soft. If you touched it, you would never even known that it was like the synthetic fibers. I did the part in the middle, but I'm wearing it like over to the side, like right here. I'll fix it. Now I have some water. Lay some of them so it's gonna be so big. And I have my and you see how I put that water in there? And them curls bounce right back. You see me literally just brushing this. I haven't even trimmed the ends or nothing yet. Yes, I'm brushing through this. Mind you, this hair was $20. This is, let me get the pack again. What I have here is the Kemma Master. I got it at my local beauty store and it was $19.99. One pack. That's my little gray up there, so I'm gonna add my little dye right there in the corner. I might have to take this outside so you can see in the light. All right, I'm outside in the light. I'm in the sun so you can get a better look at the hair. Gray, I will cover that up. Here to look at the hair itself. Alright, so, it's beautiful. Remember, this pack was $19.99. One pack. Kemma Master. Thank you for watching.